Hello, and a very warm welcome to this, your Nelson College induction process. My name is Bruce McLaughlin, and I'm the manager of the Knowledge Exchange Centre, or KEC for short. A little bit more on the Knowledge Exchange Centre for you later on. After these welcomes and introductions, there'll be some important safety information about your life with us at the college. Then we're going to tell you a little bit about Nelson College London itself. That will be followed by some details about the specific programme that you have signed up to be a part of. We'll have some data and IT information. That will be followed by a section on human resources and student support. We've got a little section on the college's libraries, and then, as promised, a little bit about the Knowledge Exchange Centre before we have a few closing remarks. Following this induction, and indeed throughout your life with us at the college, you may want to find further information, and we've got a number of great places where you can do that. Of course, there's the college's website itself, where you can find lots of information about your life as a student, about us as a college. Obviously, there's things like our policies and our procedures. There are a number of resources, and there's a really useful Who's Who section. In that, you'll find photographs of all the members of staff, together with their job titles and indeed their email addresses, as you'll find that all of us here at the college love to hear directly from you, our students. We do have an open door policy. Next, I'd point you towards our YouTube channels. There are two of those, one of which is the main college one and one of which is for the Knowledge Exchange Centre. I really would strongly recommend that you subscribe to both, as there's content being published all the time. You'll find things to do with your course itself and the subjects that you're learning about. There'll be general information about studying as a whole, but also there's things there that will help you with your career planning journey. Lastly, we're very active on social media, so do feel free to subscribe to us on any of the platforms that you also follow. During these presentations, you may find that you have some supplementary questions that you'd like to ask us. If that's the case, then below this, you'll see a little comment section in the YouTube video, and feel free to ask any questions that you would like to using that comment facility. We've got a number of colleagues who are sitting online waiting for those comments to come in so that we can respond to you. Of course, you can still follow up with your lecturers or with key academic staff or key administration staff once these inductions are over. Next, some key safety information. At the Gants Hill campus, we have a number of first aid providers and indeed fire marshals. I shan't read through all the names on the list, although obviously you can see them on the screen there, but you'll find that those names appear in posters all around the college so that you can familiarise yourselves with those people as you're getting to know people around the college. In terms of first aid kits, you'll find those in four locations within Gants Hill. One is located on the reception desk on the ground floor. We then have a second one, which is on the first floor in the staff kitchen. There's a one on the third floor, which is in the student common area. And then lastly, there's one on the fifth floor, which is in the small pantry area near the classrooms on the fifth floor.
Our first aiders and fire marshals at Ilford campus. We have Siraj Islam. He's available in room 403. And in 407, you can find Amir Mahmood. Also in room 407, we got Kamran Islam. And then we got in room 406, we got Parbrat Basan. And we have in room 412, we got Tatiana Russell. And in room 407 as well, we got Romella Joseph. So these are all the first aiders in the Ilford campus. We have two fire marshals. You can find Chandi Danji in 413 and also in room 406, Parbat Basin. In our Ilford campus, you can find first aid kits on the first floor at reception, outside the room 406, and outside the kitchen. On the second floor, you'll find a first aid kit in our IT lab. Toilets are located on every floor. Fourth floor toilets are for staff only, and the kitchen facilities are available for students both on the second and fourth floor.
We have toilet facilities located on every floor of the college. You'll find these at opposite ends of the corridor, and they alternate between floors. So if the corridor that you're standing in has a gents in front of you and you're looking for the ladies, you know you're going to be the opposite end of the corridor, and indeed vice versa. We take fire, of course, very seriously at the college. We test our fire alarms very regularly at 11 o'clock every Thursday, and we also carry out the occasional unannounced fire drill. So if you do hear the fire bell ringing at any other time other than that Thursday test, then do please proceed to leave the building using the stairwells, and please do not try to take the lifts. If you're in the Gants Hill campus, then your assembly point is in the Burger King car park, which you'll find if you turn left as you leave the entrance of the college. If you're in the Ilford campus, then the assembly point is just outside the building in front of the college. Next, we have some words of welcome from Geoffrey Alderman, who is the principal for the college.
It gives me great pleasure to welcome you as a student at Nelson College, London. The mission of Nelson College is to offer access to higher education to people from the widest possible range of backgrounds, enabling them to transform their lives through the acquisition of the knowledge and skills that they need to succeed in their chosen careers. With that in mind, my task and that of my staff is to ensure that your time at the college is marked by a high quality learning experience, so that your independent learning skills are fully developed with all the support, advice and encouragement we can give you, making learning enjoyable as well as meaningful. I encourage you to review this handbook, which sets out the standards of service which Nelson College aims to provide, what the college expects of you, and the quality of the service that you are entitled to expect from us. If you have any problems concerning your programme of study, please do not hesitate to contact the relevant department. Meanwhile, I would like to take this opportunity to wish you every success in your academic career at Nelson College.
My name is David Douglas. I'm the Head of Programme Delivery for Nelson College, London. Nelson College is registered in both England and Wales, and we have two campuses, one in Ilford and the other in Gants Hill. The college is recognised as highly trusted by UKVI, though we do not provide any programmes currently for Tier 4 students. We offer the following courses at Nelson College, London: HND Business and HND Hospitality Management with our awarding body, Pearson's. Also, in conjunction with London Metropolitan University, we offer our foundation degrees, FDA Business and FDA Hospitality Management, our BA top-up degrees, again in Business and Hospitality Management, and two MA International Business postgraduate degrees, one in Management and the other in Hospitality. Your progress in studying at Nelson College may start with one of our Level 5 programmes, either HND or indeed one of our foundation degrees. Both of these programmes are of a 2-year duration. After this, you may decide that you wish to progress to our Level 6 programme, either BA Honours Hospitality Management or BA Honours Business. And finally, our Level 7 programme, MA International Business in either Management or Hospitality. I'd now like to introduce you to the Executive Board of Governance for Nelson College, London. In the first instance, we have our three founding directors, Mr. Nazim Uddin, Mr. Atikal Islam, and Mr. Shiraj Islam. Each director also holds a senior management position within the college. Mr. Uden as Head of Quality Assurance, Mr. Atikal Islam as Head of Administration, Finance and HR, and Mr. Shirat Islam as Head of Marketing and Work-Based Learning. Then we have our Principal, Professor Jeffrey Alderman, and Alexandra Osinagova, who is the Head of Academic Services and Safeguarding.
It's now my pleasure to introduce you to Mohammed Shakil Haq. Mohammed is the Assistant Academic Manager for the London Metropolitan Programmes.
Hello everyone, my name is Mohammed Shakil Haq. I'm Assistant Academic Manager for London Met Department. Let me introduce a London Met Programmes Management Team. I think you guys are already familiar with Mr. David Douglas, who is our Head of Program Delivery. Let me introduce our other management team. Gabriella Kopp, she is our Program Administrator and Academic Support Tutor. Bushra Kamali, she is our Program Administrator as well as Academic Support Tutor. Mr. Sheikh Zial Haq, he is our Course Leader and Module Leader for FDA Hospitality Management. Dr. Paul Ridout, he is our Course Leader for MA International Business Programs. Mr. Milan Mahmud, he is our Course Leader for FDA Business. Dr. Kavira Santayana, he is our Course Leader as well as Module Leader for some of the courses from BA Honours Business Courses. And again, Sheikh Zial Haq, he is our Course Leader as well as Module Leader for BA Honours Hospitality Management Program. Let me introduce our admission team. Mr. Shuman Chandra Shaha, he is our Administrator Manager. Ms. Mariam Alam, he is our Assistant Admission and Attendance Manager. Zeylan Kulukan, he is our Admission Officer. Mr. Khorshed Alam, he is our Assistant Data and IT Manager. Masudur Rahman, he is our IT Officer. Mr. Mohammed Sadiqov, he is our Assistant HR and Finance Manager. Let me introduce our marketing team. Mr. Shamsha Rahman, he is our Marketing and Recruitment Manager. Ms. Luminita Gache, she is our Marketing and Recruitment Supervisor. Ms. Sadaf Naeem, she is our Marketing and Recruitment Officer. Mr. Andy Malunga, he is our Marketing and Recruitment Officer. Mr. Zeri Aluna, he is our Marketing and Recruitment Officer. Now, let me tell about how we are going to deliver our program and what is the assessment criteria. Our classes will be held asynchronized blended learning, which is half of the student will attend physically and other half of the student will attend through Microsoft Teams, which is online. So every other week, half of the student come attend physically and other half have to attend online class, alternative every week. Our class will be start at 10 o'clock and it is going to finish at 5 o'clock. There will be two sessions, morning session and afternoon session. Morning session will be start at 10 o'clock and it is going to finish at 1 o'clock. And the morning session is all a lecturer period. And afternoon session will be start at 2 o'clock and it is going to finish at 5 o'clock. Between 2 to half 3, our lecturer will provide you lecture session and half 3 to 5 o'clock is our tutorial session. Every course and every module, we have workshop and field trips, and it is mandatory to attend all the workshop and field trips. We are going to invite all external speaker to deliver the workshop, and we are going for the field trips, which is related to your all modules. In the VLE, which is our alternating system, it is called virtual learning environment, we are going to upload all the videos and the presentation 2 weeks in advance. There will be some group tasks. Our module lecturer will be provide you how to do the group tasks. In the FDA courses, which is our foundation degree in business and foundation degree in hospital management, one module called work-based learning. So in the second semester, we are going to provide you some work experiences. Your student ID card, you guys will be collected from reception. The day you guys start your classes. Now let me tell you about you guys how is your assessment criteria. For the foundation degree, There will be some group presentation. You guys have to write a report. There will be some portfolios. Only one subject, which is you guys have to do open book written examination. You guys can have your own books. We are going to provide you the questions so that you guys give the appropriate answer. In the top of degrees, some of the modules have group presentation and some of the assessments are report. Some of the assessment, you guys have to do portfolios as well. In the research method and project, in the first semester, you guys have to do the research proposal. In the second semester, you guys have to do the research project. Now in the master's programs, all the modules, you guys have to produce group presentation as well as individual presentation. You guys have to do some report as well as portfolios. And the summer period, you guys have to do a long research project, which is 15,000 words. London Metropolitan Academic Department is going to provide you personal and academic support tutor. We have some dedicated academic and student support tutors to provide you one-to-one academic support session. As already I mentioned, in the afternoon session, between 3 to 5 o'clock, the lecturer is going to provide you tutorial session. So guys, book your slots with your module leader so that they can give you 10-minute slots to provide you face-to-face, one-to-one academic support session. We are going to provide you personal academic tutor who will act as the first point of contact for any other academic problems. So in your academic timetable, we are going to provide you the academic support tutor's name. If any student's attendance is gone below 60%, and during the first semester, some of the students didn't pass the assessment, what we are going to do, we are going to put those students as a student at risk. So our academic and personal academic tutor will be work together and provide you individual learning plan so that you guys can complete your modules and regularly attend all the tutorial and lecture session. Dear students, please go to our Denson College website. You guys are going to find the attendance and assessment deadlines policies. I already mentioned that during the interview, make sure you guys attended more than 60% all your tutorial and lecture classes. All your assessment you guys have to submit through our turnitin system, which is VLE, Virtual Learning Environment. We are going to open a submission deadline, and during your first week of classes, we are going to provide you the deadline so that you guys know when to submit through Virtual Learning Environment. As a student, you have to submit your assessment by yourself. Let me introduce course structure for MA International Business in Hospitality Path. In the interview session, we already explained how we are going to run in MA International Business Hospitality. There will be three semesters: autumn semester, spring semester, as well as summer semester. In the autumn semester, we are going to teach you three modules. First one is business research and study skill. Second one is assembling and managing high performance teams across culture. And your third core module called strategic hospitality management in a global environment. In the spring semester, we're going to teach you three modules as well. The first one is international digital marketing. Second one is managerial application of finance in the global economy. And the third one is managing international hospitality experience. In the summer semester, which is your research projects, you guys have to do 15,000 word dissertation, and the subject score is international business research project. For the MA international business management path, I already mentioned during the hospitality path, MA students is going to have three semesters, which is autumn semester, spring semester, and summer semester. For management part, autumn semester, we are going to teach you business research and study skill. The second module is called assembling and managing high performance teams across culture. And your third core module is transformation and change leadership in a global context. In the spring semester, we are going to teach you three modules as well. The first module is international digital marketing. The second module is called managing application of finance in a global economy. And your third core module is called international entrepreneurship and innovation. During the summer period, you guys have to do international business research project, which is 15,000 won.
Thank you so much to allow me to take a part. Hi, my name is Kiran. My full name is Koshitalum Kiran. I like to be called Kiran. Okay, so I'd like to introduce myself a little bit. So I am an assistant IT and data manager, and I'm responsible for data and IT. And also, I'm going to talk about something, your virtual learning platform, which is called VLE. So I'm going to talk about doing this. So what is VLE actually here for? You can learn, you can access your class materials in online, and also you can come into the college and physically access our library, other parts of it. So because of these unprecedented situations, we introduce our online classes, so you can access from your home, or if you come to the in college, then you can access as well. So the VLE is meant for, it's a learning platform designed to provide you a secure and integrated systems where you can personalize your learning environment. So as you can see in the screen, there is a login page where you can connect with the NCL Office 365, which is we newly introduced it to access your online classes. So you will be provided your username and password and college email ID actually, then you can access the online classes. We will show you this once you all things is done. Okay, so next thing I'm going to talk about how we'd work it out. So some couple of things you need to make sure: you shouldn't share your username and password to anyone, because this is your where you can submit your assignment. In this college, we don't have any exam, so all you can do to write your assignment and submit to the VLE, where it will be tested, or you know, these tested by Turnitin software, which is test your plagiarism. The plagiarism is for this means did you copy, or how much you copy from online resources. So your teacher or lecturer will talk about this in this classroom. So once again, thank you so much. That's all from me. You can have my email ID or my phone number will be provided to you if you have any problem to your learning, virtual learning environment, and also IT problem. I'll be with your assistant. Thank you so much, and once again, good luck. Thank you. And I will pass to my next colleague, Tatiana. She will tell you about human resources. So thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Alongside Tatiana, looking after our student welfare, we also have Lucia Ismail and Hira Khan.
At Nelson College London, we strongly believe in equality, diversity, fairness, and respect for all. We are committed to ensuring equality of opportunity for our students and staff. The college does not discriminate against individuals with disability, mental health condition, specific learning difficulties, or long-term conditions. Any disability disclosure will be dealt with confidentially and sensitively. The college is committed to addressing any individual support requirements and making reasonable adjustments to ensure that students enjoy college experience and achieve their full potential. Such adjustments will be determined during the one-to-one meeting with the disability support officer and with support of evidence submitted by the applicant or student. It is the responsibility of an applicant or student to obtain appropriate medical or psychological evidence and submit it to the college. Evidence must not be more than 4 months old, must be written by a medical professional in accessible English. Any evidence should, wherever possible, identify specific areas of difficulty in relation to study-related problems. Students with disabilities or learning difficulties might be offered blended learning sessions to support their studies. You will receive personalized timetable for online study, additional support from the blended learning support lecturer, and extra activities to support the learning. The student welfare team at Nelson College London supports students with disability as well as caregivers. A caregiver is any adult who has spent time in care as a child, including those who have been adopted, estranged, and unaccompanied asylum seekers. Our committed and determined staff support and help caregivers to build their skills and get into the employment world. A caregiver will receive guidance and support during the application process, a pre-sessional induction event, on-course support, financial support, and one-to-one sessions with the student welfare officer. The college can offer financial help to all students. Students who experience unexpected financial difficulties due to circumstances which could not have been predicted at the start of their course can apply for the NCL Hardship Fund. The college can offer the NCL Bursary Package to students with disabilities or caregivers.
Thank you, Tatiana. I'm going to talk about myself. First of all, my name is Noor Mia. I'm the Library and Learning Resource Officer. If you need me, you can always find me at the library. Whenever you're visiting there, I'll be there all the time. Anyway, let's talk about the library. The Library Resource Center is located in the Gansiel campus. We have an inventory of over 1,000 books available to borrow. Core and recommended textbook references can be found in your unit handbook. You will have access to Redbridge Library, located in Ilford, and other public libraries, as well as access to academic journals, study manuals produced by the college for each unit and module made available on VLE. Printed copies can be available upon on request. Computer lab, Wi-Fi, printing facilities are available for use at the college. Thank you very much for listening. And now I'm going to hand over to Casey.
Thank you, Noor. Hello, everyone. My name is Kashla Rowlands, and I'm the Employment and Workplace Manager here at the KEC. My role is to basically make your career journey that more manageable and, of course, enjoyable. Here at the KEC, we pride ourselves on all things career related, and we hope to bring you endless opportunities. We know you guys are here to get the best job, and we'd like to support you with that. We'll do stuff like CV writing workshops, LinkedIn workshops. We'll even provide you with career advisors to help you along the way. We know you're getting tons of information today, so why not check out our KEC website and also our social media platforms. For now though, here's Varuni, who will now take over. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Kashka. Welcome to Nelson College. My name is Varuni. I am part of the KEC team. The learning takes place in so many different and exciting ways. One of those is the workshops we organize. We invite industry experts to deliver workshops to discuss how theories and the concepts you learned in the classroom are applied in the real world. We also organize field trips. These are designed to bridge the gap between the classroom and hands-on experience. We try to give you a unique experience by traveling to the venue and spending time discovering how to link those theoretical concepts you learn in the classroom in a practical environment. As Bruce said in his introduction, subscribe to both Nelson College and Knowledge Exchange Center YouTube channels. There are many short videos that will provide you skills for life, those range from technical tips to career advice. I would recommend you check these out. We also produce a series of publications on various topics to help you learning, researching, and life beyond the college. They are in e-format, so you can read them on the go. That's all from me. Looking forward to meeting you all soon. Enjoy your journey with us. Thank you.
The Prevent Duty derives from the 2015 Counter-Terrorism Act. It applies to all relevant higher education bodies, which for this purpose are legally monitored by our regulator, the Office for Students. Relevant higher education bodies, of course, includes Nelson College London. The duty places a legal obligation upon Nelson College London to assist the government in carrying out its prevent strategy. This strategy, following government guidelines, is designed to respond to the ideological challenge of terrorism by preventing people being radicalized through extremist ideologies. And extremism is defined under the Act as vocal or active opposition to fundamental British values, including democracy, the rule of law, individual liberty and mutual respect, and tolerance of different faiths and beliefs. Accordingly, the College has adopted its own prevent strategy, which sits alongside a code of practice on freedom of speech. Both have been approved by the College Board of Governance. To assist us in this work, we've also established a prevent steering group, which meets once every 3 months. The Redbridge Prevent Education Officer is a member of this group, and the College itself is a member of the London Prevent Network established by the Department for Education. That group has regular meetings, and of course we attend these meetings. We also periodically here at the College carry out a risk assessment to ensure that our strategy is continuing to be effective and fit for purpose. Now, it's also important to note that Prevent is part of a wider College safeguarding initiative. The College is passionate about safeguarding its learners and staff and aims to protect adults at risk from all types of abuse and harm. We take all safeguarding concerns, including suspicion, seriously, and will report concerns promptly to the relevant authorities. Should any student experience any safeguarding issue, this should be reported immediately to their lecturer or directly to the designated safeguarding officer. The details are on our website, so that suitable help and support can be provided. I do hope you'll all look at our College website for further details of all these important initiatives.
The Office for Students replaced the Higher Education Funding Council for England in 2018 and is now the main regulator for higher education. The Office for Students ensures that positive outcomes are achieved by the provider for students. This means that education providers should ensure that students from all backgrounds, particularly the most disadvantaged, should be able to access, succeed, and progress from higher education into either further study or employment. And I am proud to tell you that Nelson College London was one of the first colleges in the London area to be registered at the approved fee cap level, which is the highest level of registration available. Our current access and participation plan for the next 5 years is available on our website. Please take the opportunity to view that plan, where you'll see our targets and commitments that we've made for the student experience in the coming years. The College is a very student-focused college. Each year, for each group of students, we select 2 student representatives. In fact, these are selected by their colleagues on the courses. These student representatives attend most of the management committee meetings in the College, including the programme committees, the academic board, the academic planning committees, and the student representative committee, where all student views and opinions are considered. Part of the benefits for students attending these meetings and being a student representative is that we do pay a small amount for attendance, and we do provide free training throughout the course of the year.
Well, there we are. That more or less concludes our induction video. I do hope that you found all the speakers both interesting and indeed informative, and that you've learnt lots more about the College and that the course that you will be attending. Don't forget all of those useful sources of information that I mentioned for you. Feel free to browse those at your leisure. But of course, don't also forget that if you do have any questions that you need to ask, please feel free to contact people from marketing who you first met, or indeed your college lecturers once you started the course, or of course anybody from the academic or administration teams. Look forward to seeing you in and around the College in the future. Thank you very much for your time and attention to this video.